In remote villages in Koshibando region of the Democratic Republic of Congo's Bandundu province, thousands of children are brought for vaccination against measles. It's the world's largest outbreak, having killed more than 4,000 people, many of them children. This death toll is higher than that of Ebola in the east of the country that has killed 2,000 since the outbreak began in 2018. Bandundu is one of the most affected provinces. Many children have died, more are critically sick. Luis Madidi's children have been unwell for nearly 2 months.
My four children have measles, and two of them are too weak to walk. I tried to treat them using alternative medicine. I hope the vaccine will help.
These children can at least access treatment. Many others live in more remote areas where there are no health centers and security is a problem.
The conditions in some hospitals are dire. There are no medicines, no money or any kind of medical aid coming in. We have many cases of measles worse than what you're seeing here.
You don't have to go very far to see children in very poor health. This is the main hospital in Koshibanda. Children with measles are treated for free, but many are brought in when it's too late.
We try to vaccinate as many children as we can, but the problem is we don't have appropriate equipment or money for logistics like travel to areas where there are no health centers.
Medical aid agency Doctors Without Borders says nearly 2,000 children have died since January in Koshibanda. More than 200 cases are reported every week.
We have to make choices, and very difficult choices, because we have to choose where to go, and when we decide to go to one place, we know that we are abandoning other potential beneficiaries. So MSF is appealing to have a bigger response, and response means medical care to patients who are sick, means urgent vaccination, and means improved surveillance system.
For now, health workers have to do what they can with limited resources to make sure as many children as possible are vaccinated. Catherine Soy, Al Jazeera.